Hi, this is Rexel, and I daily upload custom ROM review, custom ROM updates, custom ROM flashing guide. If you enjoy watching content like this, then consider subscribing the channel, and don't forget to turn on the notification bell to get notified whenever I post new video in the future, right? And this is Spark OS Android 12, the latest build. This is the latest build, and if we go to settings, let's go to settings, about phone, you get to see Android version 12, right? Android version is 12. If you double tap on it, and if we move to 12 o'clock, we get Easter egg, right? And the security patch is 5th November 2021, and Spark OS Storm Official Rafael 2021 116 GApps build, and the kernel is Soviet Star. SE Linux status is enforcing, then it's good. And if we go to Play Store settings, about, you get to see device is certified, right? And here let's test safety net result. And this is the result. The safety net is success and it passed. And this is the AnTuTu benchmark score, right? And this is the Geekbench score of this ROM. Multi-score 2,528 and the single score is 738, right? And you get here, if you go to DRM info, you get security level L1, right? This is good, right? This is the CPU throttling test. I run the test for 6 minutes and 49 seconds, right? And this is the result. Max 202,000 and average 185,000 and the minimum is 173,000 GIPS, right? This is the low chair launcher alpha 4 you get here. Home settings, you can see here low chair 12, right? This is 12.0 alpha 4. And you can go to general and accent color system, right? Themes. And if you can enable theme icons here. If you disable, enable. If you enable this, you get this theme icons of Android 12, right? Here you get to see some customization here, fireworks, themes, lock screen, status bar, gesture, miscellaneous power menu, right? These are the customization you get here. Modded engine here, lock screen, gesture, status bar, so traffic network, so 4G VoLTE icons, miscellaneous, so CPU info, kill app button, power menu, advanced restart, enable disable option. And you don't have thermal profiles here, right? And you have custom display setting, you have DC dimming, high brightness mode, wallpapers and style, you get wallpaper colors, basic colors, right? And on the left side in your home screen, you get Google Feed. And we have screen recorder, internal and external audio, right? Okay, it's recording now. And the screen recorder is smoothly. The screen recorder is smooth. Here you can see the screen recorder is going on. With external and internal audio, right? Okay, the screen recorder is working. The camera here, QR scan, camera, video, you don't have much options. Okay? And you can record your video in Full HD and Ultra HD, right? But you don't have much feature in this camera. And if we go here, widgets, you get all the widgets that you get in Android 12. Clock style, right? Do that. And now to install this custom ROM, we will be using OrangeFox Recovery, right? Okay, so install it. Okay, so to install this custom ROM, we will use OrangeFox Recovery, or you can use DWRP or Pitch Black Recovery, right? This is recommended. So we will use this recovery, OrangeFox Recovery R11.1_2 stable unofficial build, right? You can download this recovery zip file and let's go to flash. Okay, first we will flash OrangeFox unofficial raw file that is recommended by the developer, right? It's mentioned, right? So we will flash the recovery file, recovery zip file, select and swipe to install. Once this is installed, it will automatically reboot into recovery, right? It's rebooting. It reboot. Now we will flash or wipe some partitions, right? Now go to wipe and select Dalvik cache system vendor data and swipe to wipe. This is the clean flash method I always do. And now okay, where is the file? This is the files I will flash Spark OS GFS build. If you are flashing vanilla build, then you will need GFS, right? You can use Nick GFS, Flame GFS, Android 12, Open GFS. Those are some GFS. Now, first select Android 11 firmware, add to queue, then select Spark ROM, right? Android 12. Now swipe to install. Now this will take little bit of time, so please be patient while flashing custom ROM. Okay, it got flashed, right? Firmware and Spark OS has been flashed, installed, right? Now if your phone is encrypted, go to wipe and format your device. Type YES and then click the tick mark to format. Now, okay. If you are encrypted, format and reboot your device. Now, I am decrypted, so I will flash DFE. And this DFE is for F2FS only. If your data partitions is not in F2FS, then you will need to flash normal DFE file, right? I'll give the link in the description of DFE zip file, and this DFE file is only for F2FS, so I will flash this DFE as my data partitions is in F2FS, right? Swipe to install. Reboot system now. Now if you are decrypted, you just need to flash normal DFE file, right? That is around 5.4 or some MB size. Spot the light loops, and here you go to the setup. You can set it off and enjoy the new custom ROM. And that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching. And if you enjoy watching content like this, then don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe the channel and turn on the notification bell so that you get notified whenever I post new video in the future, right? Thank you. I will catch you in the next one. Peace out. Goodbye.